Hello everyone, today we begins with the chapter number 4, Anemia.
Introduction. Anemia is a major killer in India. Statistics reveal that every second Indian woman is anemic. One in every 5 maternal deaths is directly due to anemia. Anemia affects both adult and children of both sexes. Although pregnant women and adolescent girls are most susceptible and most affected by this disease. So this is the basic introduction about the anemia. Now the definition of anemia, most important. Anemia is a clinical condition which is characterized by decrease in oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, either due to decrease in total RBC count or decrease in hemoglobin concentration or both. So anemia, the word consists of an means without and emia means blood. The definition of anemia is most important for theory viva as well as practical viva. When the hemoglobin concentration is less than 13 gram percentage in adult male, 11.5 gram percentage in adult female, 15 gram percentage in newborn, and 9.5 gram percentage at 3 months of age. Whenever the hemoglobin concentration below this value, then the condition is known as anemia. Low RBC count less than 4 million per cubic mm is usually, but not always associated with low HB level in anemia. This means that if the RBC count is below the 4 million per cubic mm, it may possible that the hemoglobin level either decreased or normal. Grading of anemia depending upon level of hemoglobin. Mild anemia, whenever the hemoglobin value is 8 to 10 gram percentage. Moderate anemia, the hemoglobin level is 6 to 8 gram percentage. And severe anemia, when the hemoglobin level is below 6 gram percentage. So this is the grading of anemia depending upon the level of hemoglobin. So mild anemia, when the hemoglobin concentration is 8 to 10 gram percentage. Whenever the hemoglobin concentration is 6 to 8 gram percentage, the anemia is moderate anemia. And whenever the hemoglobin value is less than 6 gram percentage, the anemia is severe anemia. Pathophysiology of the anemia. Whenever there is a decrease in RBC count, hemoglobin concentration or hematocrit. Hematocrit means packed cell volume. Whenever there is a decrease in RBCs, hemoglobin or HCT level, diminished O2 carrying capacity means a decrease in oxygen carrying capacity of the blood, which causes hypoxia, and hypoxia induces effect on organ function. Hypoxia means whenever there is a lack of oxygen at the tissue level, the condition is known as hypoxia. So due to this, there will be the sign and symptoms of anemia we are going to see. But before we are proceeding toward the sign and symptom, we are going to see the classification of anemia. Classification of anemia, first is on the basis of cause. And the second one is on the basis of morphology. Morphology means size and shape. On the basis of cause, blood loss anemia. Blood loss may be either acute blood loss or chronic blood loss. Acute blood loss in the conditions like accidental blood loss or hemorrhagic conditions. And chronic blood loss means bleeding which occur inside the gastrointestinal tract either due to peptic ulcer or duodenal ulcer. Inadequate production of normal blood cells, that is also the cause of the anemia, and excessive destruction of blood cells. This is the classification of anemia on the basis of cause. Now the second one is the morphological classification of the anemia, which includes the normocytic, microcytic and macrocytic. Now the types of anemia. Iron deficiency anemia, excessive loss of iron, that is the cause. Women are at a risk because menstrual blood and growing fetus. during the pregnancy, women having a more tendency for the iron deficiency anemia. Second one is the megaloblastic anemia. It is due to less intake of vitamin B12 and folic acid, and red bone marrow produces abnormal RBCs. So that is the reason behind the megaloblastic anemia, due to deficiency of vitamin B12 and folic acid. So the megaloblastic anemia consists of both the vitamin B12 deficiency as well as folic acid deficiency. Patients who are taking cancer drugs, they are more prone for the megaloblastic anemia. Next one is the pernicious anemia, means inability of stomach to absorb vitamin B12 in small intestine. So this is the pernicious anemia, and these all are the nutritional anemia, please remember. Hemorrhagic anemia, excessive loss of RBC through bleeding, stomach ulcers or menstruations. Hemolytic anemia, RBC plasma membrane ruptures. It may be due to parasites, toxins or antibodies. Thalassemia, as I already mentioned, or I already told you about the thalassemia in my previous lecture. So less synthesis of hemoglobin, or whatever the hemoglobin synthesized, it may be structural abnormal, found in the population of Mediterranean Sea. Sickle cell anemia, hereditary blood disorder characterized by red blood cells that assume an abnormal rigid and sickle cell. Aplastic anemia, due to destruction of red bone marrow caused by toxins, gamma radiation. So this is the sickle cell anemia and this is the aplastic anemia. Now the types of anemia, or simply we can say the morphological classification of anemia. Normochromic normocytic anemia, whenever the MCHC, means mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration level, is normal, as well as the MCV, means mean corpuscular volume, is normal. This includes the anemia of chronic disease, hemolytic anemia and aplastic anemia. MCV means mean corpuscular volume, means the volume of single RBC, and MCHC means mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, means percentage of hemoglobin concentration which is present in a single RBC. Now the second one is the hypochromic microcytic anemia, in which the conditions of low MCHC as well as low MCV. These include iron deficiency anemia, thalassemia, anemia of chronic disease. Third one is the normochromic macrocytic anemia, where the conditions of normal MCHC as well as high MCV. These include vitamin B12 deficiency and folate deficiency, or simply megaloblastic anemia. Now we are going to see the causes of anemia. Increased requirements. So whenever there is a increased requirement of RBC or hemoglobin, as in conditions like menstruating females, pregnancy, lactation, growing infant and children, and erythropoietin treatment. So in this condition, the patients or females are more prone to the development of clinical conditions like anemia. Second one is the increased loss. Whenever there is a gastrointestinal bleeding, menorrhagia, persistent hematuria. Hematuria means a presence of blood in the urine. Intravascular hemolytic anemias, regular blood donors, and parasitic infections. So these are the causes behind the increased loss, and in these conditions the anemia is obvious. Now the third one is the decreased intake. So vegetarian diet is the source of vitamin B12 is mostly from the animal diet. So the people who are only on the vegetarian diet, they are more prone to the development of clinical conditions of anemia. And the socioeconomic factors, decreased absorption. Upper gastrointestinal pathology, for example, celiac and Crohn's disease, gastrectomy means removal of the stomach, and medications like antacid and Zantac. So these all are the causes of the anemia. Now we are going to see the sign and symptoms of the anemia. There are two words, signs and symptoms. Whenever the patient come to the doctor and whatever the patient explains about their, whatever he or she is feeling due to certain type of abnormal condition which is present inside their body, these all are the known as symptoms. And whatever the doctor observes inside the patient or at the different sites, these are the signs. So simply, whatever the patient says to the doctor, it is the symptoms, and whatever the doctor observes inside the patient, this is the signs. Symptoms. Common symptoms of anemia: easy fatigue and loss of energy, usually rapid heartbeat, particularly with exercise, shortness of breath and headache, particularly with exercise, difficulty in concentrating, dizziness, pale skin, leg cramps, and insomnia. So these all are the symptoms of anemia. These are the common symptoms of anemia. That means the easy fatigue and loss of energy, usually rapid heartbeat, particularly with exercise, shortness of breath and headache, particularly with exercise, difficulty in concentrating, dizziness, pale skin, leg cramps, and insomnia, means difficulty in sleeping. Now the signs, we have to see the pallor of the skin, mucous membrane, palms of hand and conjunctiva. Usually we are observing the lower conjunctiva or lower palpable conjunctiva to see the pallor. The second one is the tachycardia, cardiac dilatations and systolic flow murmurs and edema. Mostly the doctor at the first visit is going to see the pallor as well as the tachycardia. Investigation part. The red cell population is defined by quantitative parameters and qualitative parameters. So first of all, quantitative parameters, which includes the investigation of volume of packed cells, which means hematocrit or PCV. The another name of hematocrit is PCV or packed cell volume. Hemoglobin concentration means the level of or the value of hemoglobin which is present inside our body. Red cell concentration per unit volume means RBC count. Qualitative parameters, which includes the mean corpuscular volume, MCV. MCV simply means that the volume of a single RBC. So mean corpuscular hemoglobin or MCH. MCH means the amount of hemoglobin which is present in single RBC. And the last one is the mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration or MCHC. MCHC. Mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration means percentage of hemoglobin which is present in a single RBC. So these all are the investigation part. Here I only mentioned about the physiological aspect of anemia, but the preventive as well as the treatment part you are going to study in the PSM and medicine subject.